Gall Tinsley coordinate type AC potentiometer, construction and working, standardization, measurement of unknown EMF. Construction and working. Two separate potentiometer circuits are enclosed in a common case. One is called the in-phase potentiometer and the other is called the quadrature potentiometer. The in-phase potentiometer is used for measurement of in-phase component of unknown voltage. The quadrature potentiometer is used for the measurement of quadrature component of the unknown voltage. Sliding contacts CC' and BB' and rheostat RR' are used for current adjustment. Here, the power supply is provided to the potentiometer by the phase splitting circuit. T1 and T2 are two step-down transformers that supply 6 volts to the potentiometer circuits. They isolate the potentiometer from the line and provide with earth screens between the windings. The supply of T2 is acquired through a variable resistor R and variable capacitor C for the purpose of phase splitting. Quadrature phase displacement is achieved by adjusting the variable resistor R and variable capacitor C. A vibration galvanometer VG is placed in series with a switch K and electrodynamometer type ammeter is tuned to the supply frequency. S1 and S2 are switches which are used to change the signs for reversing the direction of unknown EMF. S3 is a selector switch with 4 paired terminals used for applying an unknown voltage to the potentiometer. Standardization. In DC standardization, diazonal galvanometer is used instead of vibration galvanometer and it performs DC standardization by using a standard cell. Without causing any disturbance to the setting, the AC standardization is done by regulating the slide wire current till it gives a null deflection in the galvanometer. In AC standardization, vibration galvanometer is used and direct current supply is replaced by AC supply. Measurement of unknown EMF. The unknown EMF is connected across the terminals A to A'. To get the balance condition, adjust the sliding contacts of both in-phase and quadrature potentiometer. The balance condition is pointed out by the null deflection of vibration galvanometer. Worked example. A coordinate type potentiometer is used for determination of impedance of a coil and the results obtained are voltage across a 10 ohm resistor in series with the coil plus 0.238 volts on in-phase dial and minus 0.085 volts on quadrature dial. Voltage across a 10:1 potential divider used with the coil plus 0.3375 volts on in-phase dial and plus 0.232 volts on quadrature dial. Calculate the resistance and reactance of the coil.